Good morning, all of you. Today's session is for class 7. And the chapter is the third chapter, colligative properties. And the subtopic present in the synopsis 2, the page number C11. The subtopic is depression in freezing point. What is the definition of a freezing point? Nothing but the liquid converts into solid at that temperature point, then that point is known as a freezing point. Or the molecules of liquid that are in equilibrium condition with the molecules of solid. At that equilibrium condition, vapor pressure of a liquid is equal to the vapor pressure of a solid molecules. Hence, then that point is known as a freezing point. Now, while taking an example, the solid form of water is ice, and it is in equilibrium condition with the molecules of water. Then the freezing point is known as the molecules of ice that are in equilibrium with the molecules of water. And it's that the freezing point is given as 0 degree Celsius. Now, what is called the depression in a freezing point? When a non-volatile solute is added into volatile solvent, then the depression, the vapor pressure of the solution is very, very less than a vapor pressure of the pure solvent, is very, very less. The decrease in vapor pressure, decrease in vapor pressure of the solution is known as depression in a freezing point. The decreasing of vapor pressure of the solution is known as depression in a freezing point. Now, while taking a graph between a vapor pressure as well as temperature and degree Celsius. Now, the pure solvent that in a liquid form follows the path AB, vapor pressure of the pure solvent. At that point B, the appearing of a solid will start. Then, the gradually or steadily it follows the path BC, and that BC represents formation of a solid. That point B is known as freezing point of pure solid. And now the vapor pressure of a solution is always less than a vapor pressure of the pure solid. Then it follows the path D, and D it touches the BC path at the point E. And now E represents freezing point of solution. Therefore, the difference between freezing point of solution to the freezing point of pure solvent is known as change in freezing point, delta TF. Delta TF equal to T naught F minus TF. Delta TF equal to T naught F minus TF. And now here, delta TF is directly proportional to M. M represents molality. Now, while eliminating the proportionality, then we will get the constant KF. KF into M. And now, from the above terms, M represents your molality, and KF represents a molal depression constant. KF represents molal depression constant or a cryoscopic constant. Molal depression constant or a cryoscopic constant. And now the molality is given by weight of a solute by molecular weight of a solute into 1000 by weight of solvent in grams. While taking 1000, the weight of solvent is in terms of grams. While submitting the m value in the above equation, then finally you will get delta Tf equal to Kf into A by M into 1000 by W. Now what are the terms here? A, mass of solute, M, molecular weight of solute, W represents weight of solvent in grams. Now coming to the another subtopic, that is calculation of molar depression constant Kf from the enthalpy of fusion. Enthalpy of fusion. Fusion or melting. Nothing but liquid and solid that are in equilibrium condition with each other. Now, delta Tf equal to T naught of F minus Tf. T naught of F minus Tf. Delta Tf equal to R T naught square by delta Hf. R T naught square by delta Hf. D naught, T naught represents here for pure solvent. The delta Hf, enthalpy of fusion. Now R represents here gas constant. R is gas constant, universal gas constant. Universal gas constant. And now here Kf equal to R T naught by delta Hf into chi, mole fraction of solute, chi s. Now here chi s equal to ns by nr. Ns represents the number of moles of solute, nr represents number of moles of solvent for dilute solution. For dilute solutions, ns is very less than nr. Number of moles of solute is very less than number of moles of pure solvent. Then while submitting the value here, then you will get Kf equal to R T naught by delta Hf into Ns by N naught. Ns by N naught. Now here Ns equal to weight of solute by gram molecular weight of solute. N naught represents here weight of solvent by gram molecular weight of solvent. Gram molecular weight of solvent. Then the above equation will becomes Kf equal to R T naught by delta Hf into A by M divided by B by W. Nothing but W by B will get. Now the above equation becomes here delta Hf. Here delta Hf equal to W into latent heat of fusion. Latent heat of fusion, nothing but 1 kg of liquid may convert into totally into solid form. Then that amount of energy required is known as latent heat of fusion. Therefore, while submitting delta H value in the above equation, then Kf equal to R T naught by W into latent heat of fusion into A by M into W by B. W represents gram molecular weight of solvent. Now W and W may cancel each other, then we'll get the Kf equal to R T naught by LF into A by M into 1 by B. A by M, here A by M represents number of moles of solute. How many moles? 1. For 1 molar solution. Then for B represents 1 kg. B represents 1 kg, that equal to how many grams? 1000 grams. And now for 1 molar solution, from the previous equation, delta Tf equal to Kf into delta M. If in case M equal to 1, from the above equation, Kf into m equal to delta Tf. If m equal to 1, Kf equal to delta Tf. Kf equal to delta Tf. Therefore, the above equation becomes Kf equal to, the above equation becomes Kf equal to R T naught by T naught into T naught square. Because initially we have taken here delta Tf equal to R T naught square. R T naught square by Lf into A by M value 1 into B value 1000 grams. 1000 grams. And now here Lf equal to delta Hf by M1. Now in this case M1 represents molecular weight of, in this case M1 represents molecular weight of solvent. Therefore, the above equation becomes Kf equal to R T naught square by delta Hf into M1 by 1000. For 1 molar solution. For 1 molar solution. Okay, in this class, we derived the equation of depression in a freezing point. It is one of the colligative property. Thanks for watching.